Well, I think that in fact he's not far off it when it comes to romantic love. Because I do think that when you fall in love, you are not in a natural state. You are as mad as a coot half the time. You really know less about that person at that stage than you ever will again, because you're not seeing that person, you're seeing your need, I think. And so I'm very dubious. One of the things that we used to, it was interesting though, you see, because one of the things that we used to talk about a lot, Jackie and Brian and me, he had had a terrible romantic passion for a woman who he met in Poland after the war. He was working for UNRRA, and she was an alcoholic, and it had been a desperate, desperate thing. He was absolutely crazy about her. And then she'd left him and gone back to Canada. That's why he would left Ireland and went to Canada. He was chasing her. And she would have nothing to do with him. And he then married. He thought, well, I finished romantic love for me. And he married Jackie because he liked her very much and they got on terribly well and it seemed like a sensible love. But, you see, no sooner does the very, very beautiful. I think it's so awful of me. I must be blocking her name for some reason. She turns up and off he went again, you see. And that time it worked. That time it suited him very well. And her, it was a good marriage, that second marriage. It worked perfectly well. But I think, really, that being in love is a sort of unnatural and lunatic state. I mean, you're going to have a happy marriage if you're lucky enough to fall in love with someone who really does suit you. And fortunately, it happens quite often. And I've seen enough happy and successful marriages, even in my own family, to know that you really can hardly have anything better when it really works. And it can well start as being perfectly romantic and end up being very good all round. But on the other hand, it can start by being very romantic and end up by being hell, because you've just not been able. I look back at my second great love. Tony, I think, the first one, I think I understood him very well on the whole. The second one, would have gone through fire for, you know, I was so in love with him. I knew nothing about him at all. Really nothing. I mean, he was stationed across the park from me. We met, I suppose, in all about 10 times. I knew about him, what he was, what one could see, which was that he was a lovely man to look at, and that I liked making love with him. I knew that he was intelligent and well-educated and funny, but I didn't know whether he believed in God or didn't believe in God. I didn't know who he voted for when there was an election. I didn't know how patient he could be, how kind he was. I knew nothing about him. And yet, if he had said to me, come and marry me tomorrow, I would have gone like a shot. And I think it is a form of madness. I think it should be tried out. You should never marry anyone until you had a bit of a trial first.
Until you stop being in love with them.
Well, stop being madly in love with them. Till you know that the things about each other which are quite annoying in many ways, which you're prepared to put up with and that sort of thing. If you're young and you do happen to, in a romantic way, to marry the right person, that's fine because you're then together and you shape yourselves together. And so that you really do belong together in an extraordinary way. But it is largely a matter of luck. But I think that happened to my sister, for instance. She married when she was 21. and I think was, you know, quite properly in love. And they went, it was an absolutely admirable marriage, couldn't have been happier.